wear the high glam fashion look every day. So what I'm going to do is just do something natural, quick, easy, out the door. Okay, guys, I'm going to start off with my primer. I use Milk of Magnesia. I love it. I love it, love it, love it. Especially if you have oily skin, it's really good for that, and it's cheap, too. A lot of people like buying the high dollar. That's okay to do that, too. However, I love Milk of Magnesia. And I just take it, spray it in my hand, and just go all over my face with it. You always want to make sure you prime your face first. It helps your makeup to stay a little bit longer. And the Milk of Magnesia has a drying agent in it, so it helps to mattify your makeup a little bit better. I always start off with my eyebrows, and I don't like the so sharp-looking eyebrows, so I just do mine really natural. I take them, first I take my spoolie, and I just go in, straighten them out. Make sure they're nice and neat. And I actually need to shape up mine, but I don't have time for that today. So, oh well. And I'm just taking, you want to use like quick brush-like strokes. It looks like a little more natural than drawing it in for me. It's whatever your preference is, but I like the quick strokes. And the pencil that I'm using is a NK, I think that's NK, eye pencil.
Show the product. Put your hand. Put your hand behind it so they can see.
It's NK. And just go over your eyebrows. And today, I normally don't do it, but today I am going to use some shadow to set this powder, to set this pencil, because it's a wax base. And where is, here it is. I'm going to be using a NYX Nude Shadow. Can you see that? Is Dance with the Tides. I'm just taking a BH cosmetic brush a stiff brush and just going over it, fill them in. Like I said, I don't like mine to look too sharp. I like a more natural eyebrow looking. Especially if you're going with a more natural look. You don't want to be too over the top with your natural look. And go back in and just brush it. Brush it in. Now today I will go back in and shape them up just a little bit with some concealer. Okay, guys, I had to get myself together. I lost some of my stuff. I had to find it. I'm going to go in and take, I'm using the MAC Pro Conceal and Correct Palette in the dark, and I'm going to use the NC45. No, that's not NC45. It is. Yes, it is. NC45 right here. I just take it and just kind of clean up. Bring that concealer down over my eyes. And like I said, I don't like the real sharp look. So I just go in and clean it up and just make it look a little more natural. And do the other eye. And I found that using a more straight line brush is better. It helps you, your lines to be a little more precise, and it's easier for you to do it. glow. You know how people have the light outlined eyebrows? I don't like that. Whatever floats your boat, but it's not for me. Oh, and the brush that I'm using is the MAC 212. Hope you can see it. Okay. So, they're my eyebrows. They're not the fancy type, but that's what I like. And they're more natural looking. So, I'm going to start with my eyes. I use Urban Decay Primer. You can see it. And I just take it, go all over my eyes. And you can use a brush, your hand, or whatever. I like using my fingers. So, just go all the way over your eyes with it. Now, if you want your color to pop a little better, you can add a white or a neutral base, but I don't want that. I just want to look straight out the door. All right, so the eyeshadow that I'm using today is a palette by Sephora. It's the Primal Instincts palette. I'm only going to be using two, maybe three colors out of here. If you can see, all of the colors are really neutral type. And they go well with a lot of stuff. So, I'm using an e.l.f. brush, the eyeshadow brush, regular e.l.f. eyeshadow brush. And I tend to use a lot of different brushes while I'm doing my eye makeup. So, once I change, I'll let you know which one I'm using. I'm going to start with this color right here. Is called Camel. It has a bit of a shimmer to it. I'm just going to put it on my eyelid with a patting motion. And you can put however much you desire. But I don't want it to be too out there, so I'm going to go back in and blend it. And that's the thing with makeup, it's the art of blending. Just make sure you blend your colors in good and everything flows really well. I want to now take a blending brush by Crown Brushes. It is the C441 Deluxe blending brush. And I'm going to take this color, it's called Prune, right here. Just go in the creases of my eyes. Just making sure you blend. And I want to kind of darken my crease up a little bit. Cut my crease in just a little more. So I'm going to take a brown and come back in with a smaller blending brush. I got this from BH Cosmetics like a year or two ago. So I can't tell you. All I know it's a blending brush. So I'm going to come in and take this matte, Brun Matte. That's what it's called, Brun Matte. Just cut my crease a little bit more. Define my crease just a little bit. See the difference in that one? This one when I added this. Yeah. take this top color right here. No, I'm sorry, the bottom color. And go all over my eye with it. And just blend it out. Blending, blending, blending. It always takes me a long time to do my eyes because I'm so particular about them. So I'll just blend, blend, blend. That's basically the look right there. Okay. So now I'm going into my foundation because I want a lighter look. I'm going to use Mary Kay, Time Wise, Luminous Wear, and Bronze One. I'm going to take a sponge and just, this is what it looks like in the back of my hand. And I love Mary Kay cleaning products and their foundation, especially if you don't like a heavy coverage. They're really good for that. So you just take it, and with the sponge, I just take it and do like a stippling effect all over my face. And this has a yellow undertone to it, but I have more of a red undertone, but once I add my powder and everything, it's going to come together. And then I'm not doing highlighting and contouring today because that's not what I want to do. I just want to have a quick out the door look. And once you start putting on your foundation, you'll be able to speed up your process, but for this, we're just going to show you how to do it in the look. And remember, if you want a more lighter coverage, liquid makeup is really good for that, unless it is specific for a heavier coverage. And I have something that is, I have a lot of discoloration. So doing this, I will show you how to neutralize your discoloration in later tutorials. But for this part, for this one, we're just gonna do this. Okay, using a gel liner is by Sephora, and it's in the Must Have, and I love it. It's so creamy, and it goes on really well, and it's waterproof. So once it's on, it's on. It's good. Just gonna take a little, put it on the back of my hand, and I'm taking the Crown Brushes C463. And it's an angle brush, so just gonna go up under my waterline. Like that. And I always remember that makeup, you can always wash it off. So if you make a mistake, just get you some makeup remover and wash it off. Clean it up. You're not always going to get everything right the first time, so don't feel bad if you don't. Just make a mistake and keep going. Clean up. And those are my line. And because I'm not doing a nighttime look, I'm not going to smudge this. I just want my line like that. Go back in and make sure my eyebrows are straight. Like I said, I'm not trying to have the glam eyebrows today. I just want them to look filled and natural. And that's what I'm doing. So this look is not a I'm ready to party walk out. It's a I can wear this to work look. Okay. So now I'm going to go Ben Nye Nutmeg for my contour. And like I said, I'm just contouring with a powder just to add a little definition to my face. And you probably, hopefully you can see that or see the difference. Once I take a picture at the end, you should be able to tell. So I'm just going in, contouring my face. Not doing too much, just adding a little dimension to my face. I'm gonna go by my nose. Usually I use a smaller brush, but I'm using the e.l.f. blush brush. By the way, I love e.l.f. brushes. They're really good, and they're not too expensive. For those of you who want to learn how to do makeup or do your own makeup, and you don't have the money to pay for the more expensive brushes, e.l.f. brushes are really good. Just take care of them. Make sure you clean them properly. They'll last longer. And like I said, I have discoloration right here. But it'll be okay. And I'm not trying to cover up all of my imperfections today. Actually, I don't try to cover them all up anyway. Because I make up me. Okay. And I'm not going to highlight today. Just because I want it to be as natural and my natural highlights to show. When I step back, hopefully you can see that. Even my nose and my forehead. Okay, so the last thing to do, well, next to the last thing to do, just gonna put a little blush. And it's a, this is, I'll put it in the bottom because I can't think of the name of it right now. But they're really good. They're highly pigmented. I got them from Camerita Cosmetics. I'll put all that in the information box. I'm just going to take, and it's in Sienna. And just do that. And then I'm going to go back with my powder brush and just blend it in. Now, last but not least, my lips. I love lip gloss. It's really cool. I'm a lip gloss freak. Today, I'm going to go back and line the same pencil that I used to line my eyes with, the NYX pencil. I'm going to use it to line my lips with. Just a quick, and follow your lip line. For a more natural look. If you have uneven lips, some people do, you just go in and learn how to correct it. Mine, for the most part, are pretty much even. And then for my lip gloss, it's going to be Pink Parfait by Mary Kay. There you go. I'm going to take it. And because I'm a makeup artist, I'm very keen on sanitary. So I will take a disposable lip brush. I hardly ever use my own products on myself because I use them on my clients. And I'm very, very particular about cross-contamination. You don't ever want to do that. So makeup artists, if you use your own products when you're doing something, make sure you sanitize, sanitize, sanitize. So I'm using a disposable brush. And just put it on. And this Pink Parfait just has a hint of pink. Not too much, but you can tell you have it on. And by the way, I do sell these packs of, I believe they come in 25. I'll have to look at it to make sure. But they are $2. For 25, which is good, especially if you're a traveling makeup artist or you have your own space. It's really good. matches my look. And I'm going to also go back in and put a little eyeshadow. I mean, not eyeshadow. Mascara. This is CoverGirl Queen Collection. By the way, shout out to Queen Latifah. I love the Queen Collection. It's Lash Fantastic in Very Black. I also have, ta-da, disposable mascara ones. They come in 25. And if you go like to Sally or someone like that, they're so expensive, like $4 for 12. But I sell them 25 for $3. Really good. So, and I'm not real big on fake eyelashes because I have my own eyelashes. No offense, because I have worn them, but I just like mine. And plus, this is a more natural look. And I go up under just a little bit. Okay. This is my natural look. Nothing too big, if you can see my highlight. Not highlight, my natural highlight, but my contour. Here. And my lip. So, I hope this was very helpful to you. If you have any questions, you can send me a message. Like I said, I'm located in Tuscaloosa at inside of Encore Consignment Shop at 6570 Highway 69 South, Suite G. You can call me, text me, email me. My email address is info@imakeupme.com. I'm on Twitter, I'm on Instagram, I'm on Facebook. So hopefully you'll subscribe to this channel, and like I said, if you have any questions, just hit me up.